presentation of colors, which I believe is next on the agenda. Now the color guard is coming forth to the far end zone and will be marching the flags to the midfield stripe. Led by the Kentucky State Police, appears to be Nelson County Sheriff and Bardstown Police Departments represented. Sing the national anthem. State Trooper Steve Campbell singing the national anthem with Garner Spartan Field as part of the honorium for the 9/11 tragedy. We're back here at the press box once again. Tom Isaac doing the camera work tonight in lieu of Steve Campbell being on the podium here. And I'm on hand with Doug Johnson, of course. Doug, this is a big ball game here tonight.
Well, it certainly is, Scott, and this is a game both teams really think they can win. Both teams have probably been looking forward to this game. Nelson County coming off a big win last week. Nelson County really just hasn't been able to get anything going their first two ball games. I really look for this to maybe be their breakout ball game.
Bardstown can't get it going, right? Nelson County got it going last week with a 27-6 win. Bardstown hasn't scored a point. Their offense anemic all year long.
Well, that's exactly right, and that's one thing I'm sure Coach Joey Downs at this point in the season really didn't think that would be a problem is their offense. They have a lot of kids back, and they have a lot of quickness out there, but so far in two ball games, been outscored 106-0, just has not been able to get anything going.
And on defense, their pursuit defense has really hurt them this season because they've pursued to the ball, the first man through so quickly they've overrun the play.
Well, that's exactly right. They play that where they put 10 men up on the line of scrimmage, and once you break in that backfield, you're gone. There's really nobody back there. So Bardstown's been giving up big plays up the middle. That could play a big factor tonight.
We'll see how it all plays out. There are some signs across the way meant to inflame the Tiger faithful. They are really pointed in their message over there.
Certainly
defending
are.
What?
Right. That's right.
So that's the way we set the field here for this afternoon, this evening's game between Nelson County and Bardstown. It should be a good one. We hope you enjoy it. We will when we return after these messages.
Farmers Bank and Trust. We're more than just a place for your checking and savings account. We're here to make it easier for you to attain your goals in life. With our 4 full-service locations, our 7 ATMs, our hometown line, and online banking, we make it easy for you every step of the way, from those small purchases to major investments. At Farmers Bank and Trust, we're more than just checking and savings. We're here to make life easier for you.
Kentucky tradition you'll find in Bardstown. Over 80 years, it's true.
at Garnis Martin Field. It's the Nelson County Cardinals and the homestanding Bardstown Tigers in the Crosstown County Bragging Rights Special here this evening on a Friday night. A beautiful night for football, Doug.
Well, it certainly is. I tell you, a great atmosphere, a good crowd out here tonight, and it's just a fantastic night for football.
Bardstown will receive the opening kickoff. Doug, did they win the toss and elect to take the ball, or did they defer?
They won the toss and decided to take the football, Scott. So interesting caller. Bardstown going to really test that offense here early in this ballgame.
So Nelson County set to tee it up and jack it off the tee and get this one underway. Smith will kick it off. Cotton is back deep to receive. The ball goes over toward the sideline, takes a hop. Nelson County has jumped all over it. They may have it. No, Bardstown.
Well, fortunately for Bardstown, they've got the football there. Boy, Nelson County coming out with a little trickery there, just a short squib kick there, and Nelson County really got good pursuit. Fortunately for Bardstown, they came up with the football, and they're going to get good field position. Scott, that's something. And that first ball game against Boyle County really gave them problems with field position.
I only saw one Bardstown play over there, and his number was obliterated by Cardinals around him. He must have made a fine play over there, and I can't give him credit for it. But it's at the Bardstown 38-yard line, first and 10, Tigers there. We'll set these offenses and defenses as we go. Nathan Richardson, of course, will call the signals for Bardstown.
Scott, Nelson County.
Pardon, Nelson County did come up with that ball, didn't they, at the Bardstown 38-yard line.
I'm looking
to go the wrong way.
Well,
here,
the referees pointed in Bardstown's direction. I thought they came up with a football. So Nelson County coming up with a big first play there. And they've got great field position here, Scott. That's something I know that they're trying to take advantage of early in this game.
Down to the 34, where it's first down and 10, and second down and six for Nelson County. And it's Harmon at quarterback. Thought that offensive set looked awfully strange when I was trying to call the play, Doug. It was the defense I was looking at.
Well, I think everybody up here was confused.
Second man through, and it's Primus, and he's gone. Look out. Touchdown, Nelson County.
Well, Scott, we talked about in the pregame, that's something that's really giving Bardstown problems. They have nobody back. They play that confusion defense where everybody's up on the line of scrimmage, and when you bust through a big hole like that, that's an easy touchdown. Ricky Primus puts points first on the board tonight that could be big here, Scott, early.
34-yard run there for Ricky Primus in the opening quarter. He scores with 11:13 to go yet in the first quarter. Heavens to Betsy. Don't tell me it's going to be another Boyle County game out here.
Well, let's hope not. But I tell you, Nelson County has a lot of confidence, Scott, and they're really looking forward to this game tonight.
The extra point is up and good, and it's 7-0. Bardstown trailing early in the opening quarter here against the Nelson County Cardinals. Cardinals jump on top 7-0. We'll be back with the kickoff after this on PLG Sports.
Is that Lance Smith that kicked that?
St. Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
Teeing the ball up there at the 40-yard line, just kind of commenting to the public address announcer, and on down the way here after that opening kickoff, Doug, and the officials gave us the signal it was Bardstown's ball, and it wasn't. Nobody else knew it either.
That's right. Everybody's confused up here, so pandemonium here early in this game.
Lance Smith kicks it deep. Cotton has it back at his own 10-yard line. Gets it up to the 20. 25, 27, and brought down there short of the 30-yard line.
Well, good run there by Jamie Cotton. Scott, if you remember last week, he was out with a knee injury. He's back, looks to be close to 100% tonight. Not going to be able to miss him. He has those yellow shoes on, so he won't be hard to spot there tonight.
Defense will key on the yellow shoe, won't they?
That's right.
So now we'll see if Nathan Richardson can get something going here. The Tigers trailing by 7 early. Shotgun situation. Richardson fakes that handoff, hands to the second man. It's Cotton. They've got his number, and here comes a penalty marker in at the tackle, which is 4 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Scott, just he's got – Jamie Cotton's going to be a guy Nelson County's really going to key on tonight as he comes in as their leading rusher. But Bardstown is going to get a penalty here.
Inadvertent face mask, I believe, a five-yarder variety.
Well, Scott, while we've got a second, let's set this offense here for Bardstown. As you said earlier, the quarterback is number 11, Nathan Richardson. The halfback is 34, Jamie Cotton. The other halfback is number 2, Wesley Sheckles, who comes back tonight hopefully full strength. The wide receiver is 22, Chris Payne. Split in, number 8, Sean Hickman. The tight end is number 7, Wesley Barnes. Center, 69, Jacob Blackman. The guards are 62, Jay Shuhas and Jason Riley. And Daniel Carey and Barrett Mangle, the tackles.
And there's a fumble in the backfield on the handoff, and I think Nelson County's gobbled this one up again. It was going to be second down and about 7 to go. Bardstown mishandles the handoff, and Nelson County comes up with it.
Well, I'll tell you, turnovers are going to play a big part in this ball game tonight. I figured field position turnovers and the defense are going to play the three big factors tonight, and Bardstown really off be rattled here early, Scott, as their offensive woes continue to haunt them.
And so now it's Nathan Richardson losing the handle on that one. Nelson County coming up with a recovery, and they have the offense in gear and going. This handoff goes to Brett Boone, who's playing even though he's dinged up a little bit, and he gains about 8 yards through the right off his right guard.
Yeah, just a nice run there by Brent Boone. Brent Boone and Ricky Primus and Lance Coulter will be the three guys to carry the football tonight for Nelson County. I'll set this offense now for Nelson County real quick here, Scott. The quarterback's at number 11, Alan Harmon. The running backs are Lance Coulter, Ricky Primus, and Brent Boone. The receiver is Billy Manning. With the tight end is Tommy Pyle. The center is Tyler Carey. The guards are Travis Cecil and Josh Beavers, and the tackles Jeremy Hill and Matt Delaney.
Primus goes out to the right side and is split left. Primus in motion across the formation, gets the ball, and is nailed in the backfield. Good tackle in there by Juhas.
That's Jay Juhas. He's a guy that's really played well for Bardstown defensively. He's a guy that I know Coach Mason's really concerned about tonight. He's tough, and he uses his quickness, and he does a good job of getting in the backfield and makes a big play there for Bardstown.
This is a loss of about 5 yards. Make it third down and about 8 to go for the first down. Good defensive move there by Bardstown. Harmon again to call the snap count. He's under center. Man in motion coming across the formation. Hand up straight ahead up the middle. Boone again, I think, carried up there and tried to crack it inside. The tackles, and not much going there. Maybe
nope.
3 or 4.
Yeah, just a good run there by Boone again. He's found a nice little hole off that right-hand side over there. And Wesley Barnes makes a stop there for the Tigers.
So that's going to roll it over to fourth down and about a long 4 for the first down. The ball in Bardstown territory down at the 26-yard line. Nelson kind of going to go for it.
Absolutely. Why not? Great field position here. Have nothing to lose down this deep.
Primus comes in motion, and there's a penalty marker that's going to go against Bardstown and give him the first down easy.
Yeah,
what the defender was thinking about there.
Just anticipated the snap count there and came across that line, and as you said, Scott, I believe it is going to go against Barson, and that will give him a first down.
Primus went in motion back toward the quarterback, and the defender thought the ball had been snapped, and he was going out on a pattern, and flat put one on him. So that'll move it to a first down situation after the 5-yard penalty. And that's something they cannot afford to do, is give them the first down.
Right. No, it's just that's just a mental mistake there. Fourth and, 4 yards to go there, Scott, and looked to have a good pass rush on that time. And just unfortunate there for the Tigers. Penalties of something that really hurt them last year, but they were good enough to overcome them. But this team right here is a kind of a rebuilding team. And as you said, Scott, penalties, they certainly can't afford to have penalties against this team tonight.
At their own 21, it's Nelson County's ball at the Tiger 21. First down and 10. They already lead by 7. We're early in the first quarter, 8:39 to play. And the handoff goes to the first man through, and very little yardage there by Lance Coulter. He's brought down as he tries to cut back into the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, good job by Nathan Richardson on the stop there for Bardstown. I just looked up, lost his footing there, Scott, as he tried to cut back to the middle. And Nelson County going to get hit with a holding penalty here.
That's the second penalty on Nelson County, one for a face mask, and this one a big one for a hold. Well, that moves them out of that excellent field position that they had.
It certainly does. That makes it a little bit longer here. They Nelson County really got a break on Bardstown's offside penalty there, but that holding penalty is going to make it first and 23 here, Scott. So long yardage here for the Cardinals.
And they're at the Bardstown 33-yard line. Harmon under center, calls the snap count, hands to the second man in through there. And that's Primus, and he gets about 3 yards back, four maybe.
At that time, they sent Brent Boone in motion and a little inside handoff there to Ricky Primus up the middle, and Nathan Richardson and West, and let me get that player there for you there, Scott, on the stop there for, that's Wesley Sheckles, I mean Sean Hickman, excuse me, on the stop for the Tigers.
So it's going to be second down and still about 16, 17 yards to go for the first down. Primus comes out, splits wide left. Back to throw, Harmon over the middle, caught by Primus. He's down at about the, he's down in first yardage territory, inside the 10 to about the 8 yard line. Ricky Primus, one-on-one coverage, and he beat his man.
Certainly did, one-on-one coverage out there with Chris Payne, and just did a little post route toward the middle there, Scott, and just a perfect throw there by Harmon. Good catch there by Ricky Primus, and gonna give him first down and goal here, Scott, inside that 10-yard line. Just a great play there by Nelson County.
So it's first and goal for the Cardinals at the Tiger 8. Bardstown rocked back on their heels in the opening kickoff series. Now, in danger of really getting down in a barrel. 7:18 to go yet in the quarter. There's a handoff, goes off to the right side of the line. Nothing there as first man through carries and no gain.
Like Nelson County really thinks they can run on that right side of the ball over there, Scott. The majority of their carries have come either up the middle or off that right tackle over there, and it's usually been Coulter's been the man to get the football. So, but a great stop there by the Tigers. Going to bring up second and nine here, or second and goal here, Scott.
Coming out here goes Chris Sanders. Check that, 32, not 22. That's Tommy Pyle. And here comes a play in there for a touchdown, and give the touchdown to Brett Boone.
Yeah, just a little screen pass there. Scott Harmon rolled out to his right, threw back over to the to a pretty wide open Brent Boone. Good upfield blocking there by the Cardinals, and that was just a pretty easy touchdown there. And these Nelson County Cardinals have really got that confidence rolling here early in this game here, Scott.
So the extra point coming up. Smith's kick is up, wobbly, but good. And so it's 14 to nothing, Nelson County over Bardstown, still in the opening quarter with better than half the quarter to go, and we'll be back with the kickoff when we return on PLG Sports.
If you've got a plan, Wilson and Muir has the financing. Construction loans, permanent loans. We can help every step of the way and at the most competitive rates available. We offer a full array of mortgage options to get you the right mortgage. Fixed rate, conventional, single, and multifamily residents, all from the folks you know and trust. So see your mortgage professionals. Wilson and Muir Bank and Trust. We're all bank for Hardin and Nelson Counties.
That make it 120 to nothing on the season?
Yep.
Doesn't look good, Doug.
Doesn't look good, nope.
Coach Downs had his team around him there at the sideline after that score. Had his finger in some faces and hammered on some face masks.
Yeah, he's not happy. I just think Bardstown's really having problems of just people finding their roles. And, boy, they just really having their woes on offense, Scott. They just can't get anything going.
Here's a short kick and caught by Wesley Barnes at the 30-yard line of Bardstown, first and 10 there.
Well, going to get pretty good field position there. Nelson County really going with a short kick again, and going to get Bardstown pretty decent field position here. But this Nelson County team is really coming here fired up tonight. And they've capitalized on Bardstown's mistakes.
From the 31, it's first and 10. Barnes splits out left with another receiver, and Richardson's the quarterback. Okay, there's a snap over to Cotton, direct snap. And Cotton does not gain much, maybe a couple, 3 yards.
Yeah, just snapped it to Jamie Cotton over there, trying to find something on the right-hand side over there. But Nelson County right on top of it, maybe picked up 2 yards.
Looks like we might be going back to the old single wing formation back
yeah,
there.
That's
huh?
right. I think Bardstown's pretty desperate. They'll try anything.
They might try anything. You're
that's
right.
That's right.
So Bardstown second down and 8. Richardson, the quarterback, hands off to Cotton. Cotton finds a little daylight and gets it up closer to the 40-yard line, to maybe the 38-yard line, well short of the first down. But wedging out a few yards here and there. I think they've tried to establish the run if they can.
Well, you're right, Scott. And both teams, you know, their bread and butter this year is really going to be the run. Bardstown has a lot of quickness back there, and, you know, both quarterbacks are in a similar situation, really not comfortable throwing the football. And look for Nelson County and Bardstown to put a lot of pressure back there. Just Bardstown's really going to have to look to break something, as Nelson County looks to be kind of like in a zone. They look like they're in a 53. They've got 8 men in the box.
And there's a timeout on the field called by Bardstown, which stops the clock with 5:15 to play in the opening quarter, and the Tigers trailing 14-0 to the Nelson County Cardinals. We'll be back after this on BLG Sports.
Hi, I'm Ben Woffen of Community Bank. When choosing a bank, you should look at more than the services it has to offer. You should look at the personal service that's provided to you. At Community Bank, we're a local bank, deep-rooted in the community, and we care about our customers and about making banking easy for you. Our staff at each of our locations pledge to give you the quality, convenient, and personal service you expect from your bank. At Community Bank, it's banking the way it was meant to be, face-to-face.
Back here as the timeout comes to an end. Bardstown back looking for a little offense. It's third down. A long 3 yards to go, Doug. They've got to come up with a gain here that's going to get them that first down.
Well, this is a big play for Bardstown. They really need to get something going here, Scott, with a little confidence, and they need this first down.
Hand off to Cotton. Cotton's the big man with the ball. He's got the first down. Gets it to the 46-yard line before he's finally brought down. Best run of the season, maybe, for Bardstown.
Well, that was an awful good run there. Jamie Cotton going out the left-hand side. Credit the line. Getting out there and giving him a pretty good hole. Finds it and picks up a first down. And I think that's big here for Bardstown.
Bardstown first and 10 now from their own 46-yard line. Their first down of the game. First down for the Tigers. They come out now, and it's Cotton again. They're going to put the game on the back of the big man Cotton and see what he can do with it. And he's carried him down into Cardinal territory.
Well, that's right. He's going to get the majority of the touches tonight. You know, comes in leading them in rushing, and you know, last year he's their top returning running back. So Jamie Cotton's going to be asked to do a lot here, just if that offensive line can really just open up holes for him. You know, that's one question mark coming in is to. Nathan Richardson hadn't had much time to pass when he's had to throw, and there haven't been many holes there, and Jamie Cotton's having to do a lot on his own. Maybe that line will grow up here tonight.
Chris Bain splits out wide to the right side. Direct snap beat to Richardson. A big hole up the middle, and again it's Cotton carrying the ball. He's got another first down. He's charging down there into Cardinal territory, down to the 38.
Well, what this does, Scott, if Bardstown continues to have success on the ground, that forces Nelson County to maybe come back to their 4-4. Right now, they're kind of in a zone. They're scared to let Bardstown get behind them. But Bardstown doing a good job of opening up holes. Nelson County, it might need to be adjustment here if Bardstown continues to have this type of success.
Chad Ward into the game for Bardstown, splits wide left. Richardson moves up under center into the eye. Second man through is Cotton. He bangs it outside. Fakes inside, goes outside, gets it down to the 25 of Nelson County.
Well, good decision that time. Jamie Cotton looked like he was just going to go off tackle, cut it back to the outside, and there was really nobody out there, Scott, and he picks up another big first down for Bardstown. He's been the man on this drive, and he's doing a lot here for the Bardstown Tigers.
Once again, it's the speed of Jamie Cotton against the defense of Nelson County. And so far, Cotton has been able to bang it upside in the middle, and then he's bounced out on that play, showed some really good ability to read the fact there was no one out there, and he can get there before anybody else can. And it's Cotton, and it's inside the tackles, and he's met at the line of scrimmage right in the hole that time. No place to go, no gain.
No, certainly wasn't. Great job over there by Brent Boone coming here and making a stop for the Cardinals. Just deplugged that hole very quickly, and Cotton nowhere to go.
The loss of a half yard, second down, and still a long 10 to go, we'll call it. Nelson County trying to stiffen up on their defense here as they're beginning to get pushed back in this drive. First time they've had to defend their goal line pretty stoutly. Richardson flips back deep. And this is Sheckles carrying the ball. Sheckles bangs it in there close to the 23-yard line before he's brought down.
Well, I know Bardstown's very happy to get this young man back. He, his first game against Boyle County, not able to play because of an injury last week. Tried to go a little bit, and I thought he hurt his hand last week, but he bounces back this week. Looks to be pretty healthy out there, and I know he's a guy that they're going to have to get comfortable with in this offense.
Cotton got a breather on that play when Sheckles came in, but it's Cotton right back out there again. Bardstown coming to the line. It's third and seven. Another big third down play for the Tigers here, Doug.
Big third down here.
Timeout going to be called by Bardstown, as I think they took too much time to get that play up to the line of scrimmage. So there's a timeout. That's the second one they've burned. We're not even out of the first quarter yet. 1:50 to go. We'll be back with more after this on PLG Sports. Back here at Garnis Martin Field. Bardstown, Doug, they've used their two timeouts out of their allotted three for the half here in the opening quarter, but Coach Downs definitely wants to get something out of this drive.
Well, he certainly does. Probably a good timeout. It looked like they were going to face a delay of game penalty there, so a third and seven. As you said, this is four down territory. Bardstown will definitely go for it if they don't get it here. That was a good timeout by Coach Downs, in my opinion.
Wesley Barnes comes out wide right. Cotton is right alongside of him. Looks like we're going to throw. We do. Here goes Richardson back, being chased. Throws it away. Incomplete.
Yeah, they're going to get a grounding here.
Grounding ball.
There was a receiver not within 25 yards of Nathan Richardson that time. And either throw it, get a grounding call here, but that's going to be a loss of down for Bardstown. So that'll bring up fourth down anyway, but a grounding penalty definitely going to be the call here for Bardstown.
Doing the chasing back there for Nelson County was big Luke Durbin. He was going after Nathan Richardson.
Certainly would. Had great pursuit, got great pressure on him that time. Looked like Bardstown was going to try to set up a screen pass, but the pressure was so good that Nathan never could set his footing and find a receiver, and going to get the grounding call here. But as you said, credit Nelson County's defense. Boy, they really put pressure back there on Richardson.
Doug, they're still showing us third down. Penalty was declined, but that should still roll the downs marker over, shouldn't it?
Certainly should. Definitely a loss of down.
Well, Richardson looks to throw on the run, lopes one down the field. It's caught and dropped, incomplete.
Well, Sean Hickman, boy, just looked to be have good an opening there on that right side, and looked to have caught the football. Looked like he may have wanted to turn and run before he caught the football there, and just wasn't able to catch the football. And boy, just a tough break there for Bardstown. Boy, they had the first down.
had the first down. That was not one of your picture perfect passes, just kind of a basketball toss down there over the defender's head and right into the hands of the intended receiver. And man, he's got to catch those kind of balls, Doug, and hang on if Bardstown's going to have any success. Well, not only in this game, but any other game.
Right, and he's comes in as their, you know, their man to go to in the receiving end. And that's a catch he usually makes just that time, unsuccessful. Bardstown going for it here, Scott, fourth down and seven.
Richardson fakes the handoff, rolls, throws over the middle, and picked off, I think, yes. Picked off by Nelson County.
I believe Ricky Promise is going to come up with the interception there, Scott. And boy, I tell you, Nathan Richardson, just not a good decision that time. He tried to hit Wesley Barnes, but let me tell you, number two, Wesley Sheckles, was wide open there around that 5-yard line and probably could have gone in the end zone. I don't think Nathan ever saw him, but boy, just a blown opportunity there. Just that's going to be a part of his decision making. He just hadn't had the experience, Scott, only his third game.
So it's first and 10, Nelson County on the interception at the 10-yard line. And a timeout coming up for Nelson County to get things underway here. We still have a minute 27 to go in the quarter. It's Nelson County 14, Bardstown 0. We'll be back after this message.
At Farmers Bank and Trust, we give the phrase banker's hours a whole new meaning. With our community involvement, we work weekends for charitable events such as Habitat for Humanity, the Bob Murray Heart Walk, Relay for Life, and the Kentucky Colonel's Barbecue. We work evening hours for community events such as the Christmas Parade, the Taste of Desserts, and the United Way. At Farmers Bank and Trust, we give the phrase banker's hours a whole new meaning.
Whistle calls, the team's back to the line of scrimmage. With about 90 seconds remaining in the opening quarter, 14-0 Nelson County, and they have the ball at their own 10. Harmon hands off, wedge it in the middle, and there's not much there, up to about maybe the 11-yard line. Goes the ball carrier.
Yeah, Brent Boone trying to go off tackle again over there, Scott. That's where he's gone a majority of the night, and a good pursuit there by Bardstown.
Second and about 9 yards to go for the first down. A minute to go in the quarter. Well, Nelson would like to get it out from beyond the shadows of their end zone here with a couple of first downs if they can. Harmon, the quarterback, under center, the pitch. And the cutback coming up. I think the ball's on the ground, Doug.
Surely did. Brent Boone's going to come up with a fumble there. And Bardstown's definitely recovered it. Boy, that's a big break there, Scott. That's one of the breaks they've needed.
Boone, I don't think ever firmly had grasp of that when he was trying to get to the line of scrimmage and take the handoff at the same time, just squirt it out.
Certainly did. And boy, I know Coach Mason, that's just something I know he did not want to happen there. Just the Bart, as you said, Nelson County really trying to wedge it out. They're not good field position. And just not a good handoff there. And Brent Boone lost the handle. Bardstown comes up with a big break here in this ball game.
First and goal from the 9.5-yard line. Handoff, Cotton hit at the line. Falls forward down to about the 7. Gain of 3.
Yeah, Cotton off the left side over there. Chance Downs in the center on the stop for the Cardinals. And boy, Bardstown look to really try to pound this on the ground in here, Scott. Boy, that offensive line really needs to come up big and open up some holes here for Jamie Cotton and company.
Boy, can you imagine that celebration if they get off the schneid of that 121-0, right? 120-0, right?
Absolutely.
Haven't scored all season. And that's going to end up the first quarter with a score. Nelson County 14, Bardstown 0. We'll return with the second quarter and more action from Garnis Martin Field. And we come back after this on PLG Sports.
St. Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
Ready for the second quarter of action, Doug. That was a pretty thrilling first quarter of play as Bardstown didn't field the opening kickoff. Nelson County recovered and went in one play later after maybe on the second play. They may have gained 4 yards the first play and then 34 yards for the end zone for the second play. After that, Bardstown again couldn't move the ball. Nelson County took it over and scored immediately. 14-0, that's where we ended the quarter, but Bardstown here after a fumble recovery at the 9 has it second down and goal from about the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Scott, this is big for Bardstown. Just the break they've been looking for, and they really need to put something on the board here.
This is Cotton. He looks and waits for his blockers to make the hole for him. Fights through there and makes it into the end zone for the touchdown.
Certainly.
The first one of the season for the Tigers.
Well, I know that's I know everybody down on that Tiger sideline will take a big deep breath because, boy, that's just something they haven't been used to seeing here in the first two ball games. Jamie Cotton off tackle. Credit that offensive line. Opened up a nice hole there, and Bardstown gets their first points of the season. And that came big there, Scott. This could be a good confidence builder for the Tigers here as we start the second quarter.
Well, Doug, we've got a new kicker out there for Bardstown on the extra point, number 47. Isn't it 47? Yeah. Well, snap, countdown, and the ball. Maybe that's 42, Doug. Is that the number we checked
earlier?
Yeah, that's
42, and we were trying to find out who this young man is. He's not on the roster, and we'll search down the press box here and try to find out who he is. But I think Travis McEnich, the kicker, is not kicking tonight for the Tigers, and I'd try to find out who this young man is.
Penalty flag on the extra point. Moves it half the distance. Bardstown elects to go for a pair instead of one. As this situation unfolds, I don't think they like the way that kick looked anyway.
Yeah, just the timing's not there. Just hadn't had enough practice there, and Bardstown going to go for two. Are probably a wise decision here.
So Bardstown to go for the two. And they've got Cotton in the backfield, Richardson up under center. Hand off, and it's to Cotton, and whistles are blowing before the play is taking shape. And now what, Doug?
It could be an offside here against Bardstown as that whistle blew or right as the ball was snapped. They're going to go against Nelson County, so that's a big break for Bardstown. That'll move it half the distance.
Half the distance.
Right. So that's really going to put them inside there close. That nose is almost touching that goal line. So Bardstown will probably go for the same thing or try to get Jamie Cotton right up the middle there.
A little surge. And it won't take much to get it into that end zone. Cotton lines up deep in the backfield. Richardson's up under center. Cotton with it. And, boy, he doesn't get much. He leans forward. I think he got across the goal line.
Now Jamie Cotton, a good run. Boy, credit Sean Hickman. He lined up in front of him and really opened up a good hole in there with that offensive line. And they get the two-point conversion. Bardstown gets 2 points here, Scott, cutting into this lead a little bit for Nelson County.
14-8 is our score now as Bardstown gets on the scoreboard. First points to have been scored by the Tigers in this season in their third game. So now let's see if they can't crank it up. We'll come back and find out what ensues when we return after this message.
If you've got a plan, Wilson & Muir has the financing. Construction loans, permanent loans. We can help every step of the way and at the most competitive rates available. We offer a full array of mortgage options to get you the right mortgage. Fixed rate, conventional, single, and multifamily residence. All from the folks you know and trust. So see your mortgage professionals. Wilson & Muir Bank & Trust. We're all bank for Hardin and Nelson Counties.
Bardstown ready to kick the ball off to the Cardinals. Richardson going to do the kicking chores, huh?
Yep, Nathan Richardson going to kick off. And
Primus back there deep for Nelson County. Yeah, this one's going to go out of bounds. Chased over there by Brandon Simpson. And so that's going to come back up to the 35-yard line.
And that's going to be great field position for Nelson County. That's a good break. And Nelson County will really try to go back probably that grounded out tight football here, Scott, as they've had great success on the ground tonight. And Alan Harmon really looking comfortable, more comfortable back there in the pocket.
And they bring the ball up to the 35 and spot it. I wonder what they were doing standing around down there at the 25-yard line. Have I missed something again?
Just a little confusion, I think, down on the field. But we talked about Nelson Cass, a great break. And going to start off a great field position here.
First and 10 for the Cardinals from their own 35, leading 14-6. 14-8, make that. Harmon to throw. Little pass out in the flat, completed. First down is gained. Look out, this one may go all the way, Doug. Scampering down the sideline. It's a Nelson County touchdown, the first play from scrimmage. Call that one from the 35. A 65-yard pass and catch for Nelson County.
Well, Scott, there was just nobody for Bardstown over on that left-hand side. Of course, that had been a Bardstown's right side. And Brent Boone, just a great little screen pass out there. Great throw by Alan Harmon. And there was nobody even close there. Good upfield blocking by the Cardinals. And that was an easy touchdown. Boy, Bardstown really looked confused defensively there.
Well, that answers that Bardstown touchdown in a heartbeat. Extra point coming up here. And Smith to attempt the extra point. It's up and he squibs it on the ground. I think that's going to be no good. That one, Mike, never got up off the ground. And it's wide left. No good. The score goes out to 20-8 now in favor of Nelson County. Well, that didn't take very much time off the clock at all, Doug.
No, it certainly didn't. Just a quick hitter there. Boy, just a great play there by Nelson County. They saw something they liked. They really spread the field that time, and Brent Boone, just an easy touchdown there, showed his speed and good athletic ability. And Bardstown, nobody came close to touching him. And Bardstown really, really, this is something I just, you put 10 men up on the line of scrimmage, and boy, if you get behind them, you're going to score.
It's Katie Barr the door.
It's a gamble, that's right.
And so far, the Gamblers have lost the majority of the rolls of the dice in this season. Last season, different story. So Bardstown set to receive this kick. And it's Cotton back there to receive it. Smith to kick for Nelson County. Kick is up, high. Cotton fields it on the run at the 10-yard line. 15 and 20, 25 and 30 and 33 before he's rolled down.
Well, good run there by Jamie Cotton. Going to give Bardstown good field position there. And I know it's part of one thing Bardstown hasn't done tonight, Scott, and we've seen it a lot of last year and of course, against Boyle County, is a little reverse handoff they have. They usually put Jamie Cotton back there, and I don't know if it's Hibbs or you could put Wesley Sheckles, but they usually fake the hand or hand the ball off and then usually fake it and come around the right side. Bardstown's gotten away with that, gotten away from doing that tonight, but Jamie Cotton going to give Bardstown good field position here.
First and 10, Tigers. Richardson, the quarterback, has two backs flanking him and hands off to Cotton. Cotton hit at the line of scrimmage and brought down right there. No, sir, say the Cardinal defenders. You're not going anywhere.
Jeremy Hill there on the stop for the Cardinals. Just a great hit over there on Jamie Cotton.
So Bardstown is second down, and they call it 9. Richardson again from the shotgun. Hands off to Sheckles. Sheckles follows two blockers to the right side, the wide side of the field, cuts it up. He's at the 45 midfield and brought down.
Well, good run there by Wesley Sheckles. They sent him in motion that time and handed him the football. And he found a good daylight around that wide side of the field over there. Good upfield blocking by Jamie Cotton. And Bardstown picks up a first down.
They move it back to the Bardstown 47-yard line. I thought he made it to midfield, but not quite. They spotted it at the 47. Still plenty of yardage for the first down. It's a good running play there for Bardstown. They had two blockers out in front of Wesley, and he was able to turn the corner and turn on the speed. Now it's Cotton. He's hitting the backfield, tries to dance back up to the line of scrimmage and can't make it. He loses two on the play.
Well, good defensive penetration in there that time by Chance Downs. That middle linebacker just did a good job of finding a gap in there and just knew exactly where Jamie Cotton was, and that's going to bring up lost yards there for the Tigers.
Second down at about 12 to go. We've 9:54 to go in the second quarter. Nelson County leading 20-8. Richardson has two backs with him. And everybody loses the football. Richardson falls on it. What kind of a play is that?
Well, they just looked very confused back there. It looked like the handoff was going to go to Jamie Cotton, but Wesley Sheckles also was there as well, so it looked like it'd be a busted play, and Bardstown going to lose more yardage here. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 17, so things going the wrong way here for the Tigers.
So Bardstown looking for some magic in the bottle here to pull this one out and get a first down. See if they can answer that long touchdown strike that Nelson County put on them. Richardson from the shotgun. And it's a pass play attempted, but it was never a pocket that formed, and Nelson County sacks the quarterback.
Well, just a great play by Nelson County. You could actually see it coming. Chance Downs really came with the blitz that time, and 32 for Nelson County. Tommy Pyle and looked to be maybe Travis Cecil in there for the Cardinals is going to get credit with that sack, but just no blocking there for the Tigers, and a big play there by the Cardinals.
So it's fourth down, and Nelson County puts a little pressure on the punt. Richardson gets it away. And this is Burba. No, check that on the other side of the scoreboard, lad. It was Simpson on the reception of the kick. Goes absolutely to the 40-yard line. Brett's not a bad return, about 5 yards.
Yeah, good job there by Brandon Simpson. Picked up, as you said, there's got 5 or 6 yards there on the reception there. Jonathan Hibbs on the stop there for the Tigers. So this Nelson County offense really have had their way with Bardstown so far in this first pass. See what they can do here with good field position.
From the 40-yard line, Harmon hands off straight ahead. Brent Boone dives into the middle and gets nothing.
Yep, good job in there by Adam Butler and Sean Hickman. And there for the stop for the Tigers, just Brent Boone just trying to bang something up there in the middle, Scott, just trying to wear this defense down as Nelson County really looks to have a little bit of a size advantage up front.
Cardinals come out, split a man wide out left. Harmon hands off to Boone coming around, and there's an opening out there. Bardstown tries to get over and shut it down at the far sideline. They do after a gain of about 4.
Yeah, just Brent Boone trying to go off left side over there. Actually, pretty close to a holding call over there by Nelson County. Very well could have been. Looked like a Travis Cecil maybe got away with one over there. I don't see a flag. Oh, I do see one now.
Yeah. There's a late conference among the officials over on the far sideline. I guess they agreed to call one, huh?
Yeah, the flag came from the side judge. It looked like over on the wide side of the field over there, but it's very obvious from up here that Travis Cecil didn't get away with one if they didn't call that penalty. So referee's right on top of it, and that's going to back them back 10.
So that's going to make it second down and about 17, 18 yards to go for the first down. Harmon, the quarterback, moves up under center. Sends a man in motion, Primus, back toward the line of scrimmage. Flips it a pass out. Underneath, it's complete. And Miles to the 44-yard line.
Jared Grunny going to get credit with the stop over there. Just a little screen pass out there to Tommy Pyle, Scott. Picked up good yardage there. Going to come up a little bit short to third and seven. Got a lot of that penalty back, though.
Yeah, they got about 10 of that 17 they needed for the first down. And now makeable with third down.
Well, this is going to be a big defensive stop here for Bardstown. They really need to shut the Cardinals down and get the football back here.
Hand off in the middle. Short yardage carry in there made by Lance Coulter. Bangs it in there and gets it up to about the 48-yard line.
Yeah, counter play in there to Lance Coulter. As you said, Scott, banging up the middle there. He's going to come up short. Looks like to be about a good yard.
Fourth down, just short of midfield. You would kind of think Nelson County might have gone for that, Doug.
Well, with the way they've, with the way their offense has gone tonight, you would have thought so, but I don't guess Coach Mason and his staff feel they want to give up that type of field position, want to make Bardstown earn their touchdown if they're going to get one here, make them go a long way.
So here comes the kick, and it's away. And everybody gets away from it. Nelson County downs it. Then around the 21, 22-yard line.
A good job by Matt Hicks for the Nelson County getting down there on special teams. And going to be, like you said, around that 21-yard line there, Scott. So long yardage here to go for the Tigers as their offensive woes have really set in here again in this first half. Did have a touchdown, but turnovers have killed the Tigers here in this first half.
So Bardstown at the line of scrimmage. Nathan Richardson. Hand off up the middle. And this is Cotton. And Cotton breaks free. And Cotton's at the 35 and at the 40. Turns the corner at the 50-yard line. Down the sideline to the Nelson County 40-yard line.
Well, great run there by Jamie Cotton, Scott. I tell you, he's a man determined not to lose tonight. He's really taking this team on his back and really taking over this ball game offensively here for the Tigers. Just found a good opening there. Credit Bardstown's line. Boy, they opened up a good hole, good upfield blocking, and that's a big play there for Bardstown.
Got a personal foul coming up here against Nelson County. They're going to tack that on to the end of it, Doug.
Well, they certainly will, and that'll be 15 yards. So, and I guess they're going to get them with a late hit there is what the understanding is here. So, boy, you tack 15 yards, and, boy, Bardstown all of a sudden goes from another 21-yard line down to Nelson County's, looks like 27.
Right. So Bardstown with a big first down and penalty tacks on more yardage. So it's first and 10 at the 27-yard line of Nelson County. And now a timeout coming up. Bardstown taking the timeout, their last one of the half, coming with 4:21 to go. And Joey Downs yanking his players over here at the sideline. They'll take time in for this message on PLG Sports.
Hi, I'm Ben Wathen of Community Bank. When choosing a bank, you should look at more than the services it has to offer. You should look at the personal service that's provided to you. At Community Bank, we're a local bank, deep-rooted in the community, and we care about our customers and about making banking easy for you. Our staff at each of our locations pledge to give you the quality, convenient, and personal service you expect from your bank. At Community Bank, it's banking the way it was meant to be, face-to-face.
Leave the coach over there saying, seize the moment, Doug. Don't let this get away from us, right?
Well, absolutely. And Coach Downs knows, they've gotten a break here. They've gotten a nice run by Jamie Cotton, and you tacked 15-yard penalty on top of it. And you really need to take advantage of these breaks you're getting, and he knows this is an important possession here for Bardstown.
So Bardstown moves up under center, does Richardson. He has Cotton deep in the backfield. But they're taking an awfully long time, Doug, to get this one off. They finally do. Richardson looks to throw, in trouble. Wraps the ball up and goes down short of the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, Coach Down's really not happy there. Somebody really didn't do something they were supposed to do. It looked like he probably set a nice play there during that timeout, and Bardstown just really looked out of sync there as Richardson just took the football and had nobody to hand it to and just kind of had to get what he could. So a busted play there for the Tigers.
Bardstown in the I formation. Hand off, second man in, that's Cotton. Cotton, it's about three.
Brent Boone there on the stop for the Cardinals. And not much there for Jamie Cotton. Got a little bit off that run, trying to go off the left tackle.
It's going to be third down, about 9 yards to go for the first down. Ball at the Nelson County 26-yard line. Let's see what Richardson comes up with here. Hand off, fake to Cotton. He's dropped back to throw and is hit in the backfield.
Yeah, just nothing there. Good pressure in there, looked like by Tommy Pyle. And try to get that other number over there. Looks like 53, Travis Cecil on the stop over there for the Cardinals. So that was a big play, Scott. They came with good pressure that time, found a good gap, and got back there to Richardson. Looked like it was going to be maybe a little quarterback draw that time, and didn't fool Nelson County at all.
So it's fourth down and long, about 13. So Bardstown will go for it. Nothing to lose here. Cotton is in the backfield. The spread formation here for Bardstown. Swing it out to Cotton. He's hitting the backfield. Going to drop before he gets to the line of scrimmage. And that'll bring the ball over to Nelson County.
Well, great play again in there by Tommy Powell. He's made two big plays in a row for Nelson County. Just knew exactly where Jamie Cotton was able to get around the blocker of Nelson County and just make a big play. And Nelson County is going to get good field position here. With 2 minutes to go here before halftime, they're going to look to tack some more, put some more points on the board here.
Well, they have it at their own 33. Harmon calls the snap count. Bardstown comes in with a big rush, and they put the hammer on Alan Harmon, but there was a penalty marker down at the line of scrimmage. Bardstown may have jumped.
Yeah, I think they may have, Scott. You're right. But, boy, Wesley Barnes sure got back there in a hurry, made a big play there for the Tigers. And as you said, this may go against Bardstown.
We'll wait and see. Well, the procedure is going to go against Nelson County.
Well, just an illegal shift there against Nelson County. Back it up five there, and they'll probably decline this penalty, Scott.
I think I'd take that play.
Sure. Absolutely.
The sack was about 7 or 8 yards.
Well, good play there by Wesley Barnes. That's really the first time we've seen Bardstown really in the backfield there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good to see. He found a good gap in there that time on that offensive line.
In fact, they say they lost 12 yards on it, make it second and 22.
35 seconds to go to halftime.
Bardstown at their own 37-yard line. First down. Bain comes out to the near sideline. From the shotgun, it's Cotton. He's going to go off tackle in the middle. And looked like he might break for more yardage than that, but he's caught for about a 3-yard gain.
Yeah, he certainly did there, Scott. Just trying to bang up the middle there. Like Smith and maybe Chance Downs there on the stop there for the Cardinals. And Coach Downs, they're just going to let this run out and take their chances here, 28 at halftime. And Bardstown, you know, did get a touchdown and a two-point conversion, but Nelson County really struck on them early there, Scott, as they're going to take a 12-point lead into halftime.
20-8 is our score. Nelson County leading the Bardstown Tigers at the end of the first half of play. We'll be back with the second half action here from Garnet Martin Field after these messages on PLG Sports.
Kentucky tradition you'll find in Bardstown. Over 80 years, it's true. Our tradition is driven by you. Conway Heaton Ford Chrysler, Bardstown.
St. Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
If you've got a plan, Wilson & Muir has the financing. Construction loans, permanent loans. We can help every step of the way and at the most competitive rates available. We offer a full array of mortgage options to get you the right mortgage. Fixed rate, conventional, single, and multifamily residents. All from the folks you know and trust. So see your mortgage professionals. Wilson & Muir Bank & Trust. We're all bank for Hardin and Nelson Counties.
Nelson County walks off the field with a 14-point lead. Make that a 12-point lead at 20-8 here. And they come back out after halftime looking to expand on that. They'll get the ball back first crack out of the box here, Doug, to start the third quarter. Let's recap the first half scoring.
Okay, Scott. Well, the first score came very, very quickly in the ball game as a little pooch kick by Nelson County recovered the fumble there and got great field position at the 11-13 mark there in the first quarter. Ricky Primus, a 35-yard TD run, and the Lance Smith kick was good. Moved us out to 7-0. Then we moved down to 6:28 there in the first quarter. Alan Harmon, a 9-yard TD pass to Brent Boone. The Lance Smith kick was good. That moved out to 14-0. Then we moved right into the second quarter where we got a first score by the Bardstown Tigers on the year at the 11:50 mark. Jamie Cotton, a 5-yard TD run. Now, the two-point conversion was good, a Jamie Cotton run. And that moved out to 14-8. And then at the 11:39 mark on a turnover by Bardstown, Brent Boone, a 65-yard TD run. Lance Smith kick was good. No good, excuse me. And that moved it to 20-8. And that's where we stand here, Scott. So a pretty good first half here. But Nelson County really struck early on Bardstown and really put Bardstown in a hole early.
I think this opening series will be very, very important for Bardstown because they will be kicking off to Nelson County. They need a big defensive stand here.
Well, they certainly do. And Bardstown just really had to get some confidence going. You know, new kids are in different roles this year, and I just don't think they've really come together here as we've gotten early in this season. But Nelson County, on the other hand, really looks comfortable offensively, really having their way on the ground. And Alan Harmon, when he's had to throw, has done a pretty good job. And credit Nelson County's defense. They've done a great job of stopping the run. But in the second quarter, Bardstown found a little bit of life with Jamie Cotton. And he's really been the man. He's put this team on his shoulders, and he's refusing to lose tonight.
And for Nelson County, this opening series, they'll want to really make their mark, make some first downs, and try to get it in the end zone to build that lead up at 20-8 as it is right now. Both teams going through their final stretching. But Bardstown is trying to establish what, a running game first, then pass?
Certainly, yeah. That's one strength Coach Downs really thought he had this year, was he had a lot of speed. He has Sheckles and Hibbs, and of course you throw in Jamie Cotton, and that gives you a pretty good nucleus for running back. It's just his offensive line really has to come around, and these backs have really got to start reading their cuts and what they need to do offensively. But Coach Downs has his work cut out for him, this team this year. He really has to give the kids a lot of confidence, and he's really had to shuffle the kids in different roles.
For Nathan Richardson, it's been a harrowing night. He just has not had any breathing room at all back in the backfield.
Well, he certainly haven't. And, of course, Travis Cecil and Lance and Chance Downs have done a good job of getting in the backfield for Nelson County. And Nathan Richardson just hasn't had any breathing room. Nelson County knows they've got to put pressure on him tonight, as he really hasn't had to throw a lot. And they know if they can get back there in the backfield and get to him, it may shake his confidence a little bit.
Well, the Cardinals leading and receiving here to start the third quarter have deployed onto the field. Bardstown kicking team is gathered around Coach Joy Downs. Officials hurry them along now, and we'll get set for the third quarter of play.
Well, as you mentioned, Scott, I think field position is really going to play a big factor here. Bardstown really needs to get down there and put Nelson County deep in their own field position and play the field position game here in the second half.
Primus is back there to receive for Nelson County. Brandon Simpson alongside. Richardson to kick it off. Here's the kick. Bounces around at the 20-yard line and is finally picked up there by Simpson. And he's hit with a nice tackle out there by Bardstown.
Yeah, Wesley Barnes, great job of getting down there in the special teams and making a good stop. And they did exactly what they wanted to. Got them pretty deep field position here, Scott. And, boy, defense for Bardstown really needs to step up here, as Nelson County probably looked to grind that ground game out again, and they've had a good job with Primus and Boone tonight.
At the 23-yard line, they'll spot it first and 10. Nelson County with the ball. Harmon is the quarterback. Sends one wide to the left side, the far side of the field, the open side. Primus stays in the backfield. Here's a handoff to Boone, drop. Alan Harmon falls on it.
Yeah, fortunately for Nelson County, he fell on the football there that time. It looked to be a little handoff inside there off that right-hand side, but not a clean exchange there. And going to bring up second and 12 to 13 yards here for the Cardinals.
So now it's second down and long. Primus splits out left this time. Boone stays in the backfield with Harmon. Harmon to throw. Gets hit as he throws. The ball wobbles over the middle of the field. Incomplete intent for Primus coming over the middle.
Now, Nelson County really sees a mismatch over there. They really like putting Ricky Primus over there with Chris Payne. And if you'll remember, Nelson County scored a touchdown on that same play. They slanted him in toward the middle. And look for Nelson County to go to that a little bit tonight. And when they see if they can get single coverage over there with Chris Payne, they're going to look to put Primus out there wide and go for it. Because there's nobody back for Bardstown.
And Harbin got decked just as he let go of the ball. He just really got nailed by a couple of Bardstown defenders. It's third and long. Harmon has two wideouts, and he calls timeout. I don't like this, he says. Something doesn't look the way I'd like for it to. So timeout Nelson County early in the third quarter. We'll have timeout ourselves and be back after this message on PLG Sports. Alan Harmon up under center. Dances back to throw. Over in the flat, complete. Wesley Barnes on the coverage. Nothing going with that one. A gain of maybe two.
Yeah, Tommy Powell, the receiver that time for Nelson County, did what he could, and just a good play, as you said, Scott, by Wesley Barnes, getting over there making a stop. Great coverage there by the Tigers.
But there is a penalty marker down at the line of scrimmage.
Surely they'll decline this, Scott, and because it's going to bring up fourth and long yardage anyway.
A penalty marker initially called against Nelson County is declined. It's going to be fourth and about 12 yards to go. Nelson County deep in their own territory at the 23-4-yard line.
Yeah, credit to defense of Bardstown. They did exactly what they wanted to do, playing the field position game here, and they're going to get good field position here on this punt, Scott.
Cardinals kick it away. Takes a big hop, a Cardinal hop, and it's covered by the Cardinals as it dances downfield. And it's going to be down around the Bardstown 30-yard line.
Well, it took a great Cardinal hop that time as that ball took off and spun back there about 20 yards. Jonathan Hibbs has to come up there and catch that football, Scott, and they would have had great field position around the midfield mark. Now they're going to be back deep around their own 30. So special teams here just hadn't been real good here for the Cardinals tonight. It hasn't been all year long.
First down and 10, Bardstown, from their own 30-yard line. Nose the ball just across the 30, make it the 31, where it's first and 10. Nathan Richardson in the backfield, and flags fly before the ball is snapped. Bardstown jumped.
Yeah, they're going to get, I think, Wesley Sheckles over here on this left side as they put three receivers over here on the left side. And Sheckles looked to have looked like he may have been trying to go in motion, but then stopped and went back to the line of scrimmage. And referee right on top of it over there, going to back it up 5 yards here.
Not the way you wanted to start a drive.
No, it's not. The offense, the time we talked about over the halftime break, Scott, it really the offense has really just been out of sync, just hadn't looked real crystal clear here. There's a lot of formations have been messed up. We've seen a lot of busted plays by the Tigers, and just not very fluid here yet.
So it's second down and 15. First and 15 on the penalty, beg your pardon. Richardson, the flat pass out here, complete. Cotton's got it, steps away from two tacklers, gets it out here, first down yardage, not quite. It's short of the 40-yard line.
Well, great run there by Jamie Cotton as Brent Boone looked like he was going to have him for a loss back there. End up evading that tackle of Boone and picking up good yardage. As you said, Scott, got back a lot of that penalty and going to bring up second and about 3 or 4 yards here for the Tigers. So a great run there by Cotton.
And he's gimpy going back to the huddle. He's kind of gingerly stepping on one of that left ankle there and giving him some trouble. He'll try to walk it off at the 39-yard line. It's second down and about 2 to go for the first down. Cotton and Sheckles are in there. And the handoff is to Sheckles. He goes wide to the right. Got his first down. Gets to the 45, 50, 45, 40-yard line of Nelson County. Down to the 35. Wesley Sheckles, a good run.
But Bardstown does a great job. They like to send Wesley Sheckles on the wide side of the field. That time they sent him motion. He had his full speed ahead. Good upfield blocking there by Bardstown. And just a nice run there by Wesley Sheckles. He might be the guy they've just been missing in their first two ball games, Scott. They really need this young man to come on. They need somebody else besides Jamie Cotton in that backfield to make something happen.
Cotton looks to have a cramp in his calf there, Doug. He's down on the court in front of the bench. Out of the game for this series, or at least for right now. It's first down and 10. Deep snap, and this is Hibbs. Hibbs carries the ball, goes laterally along the line of scrimmage, now turns upfield, down to the 20-yard line. And now inside the 20, down to around the 17-yard line goes Hibbs.
Well, great run there by Jonathan Hibbs. Bardstown goes to the left side of the field. That time, good upfield blocking again by the Tigers. And Bardstown really sees something they like. Scott, they're really using their speed to go on the outside of Nelson County. And two great plays there by the Tigers. Put them down here with another first down, and they're really getting down here close, Scott, knocking on the door.
First down and 10 at about the 17, where it's Tigers ball looking for points here in the third quarter. Deep pitch, it goes to Cotton. Cotton gets to the outside. The pursuit is there. He tucks it back in. Gets a first down yardage, I think. close to first down.
That certainly is a great runner that I think is going to be come back here. I believe Bardstown's going to be hit with a penalty. But, boy, I tell you, Jamie Cotton, well, let's take it back. Bardstown's clapping, so this may go against Nelson County. But, boy, it was just a great run by Cotton there, Scott. I tell you, he and Jonathan Hibbs, two great plays there. And this penalty, they'll probably tack some more yardage here on it. Maybe a half the distance of the goal deal here.
Penalty was thrown way back in the Bardstown backfield. I don't know what kind of a penalty they called on that, Doug.
Still hadn't seen an indication, but looks like it's definitely going against the Cardinals.
Well, they haven't given a definitive description to us as yet.
And they may decline this.
Holding, defense. I think they tell them to pick the flag up, they'll take the play, huh?
Absolutely. Just another good run there. Got the first down anyway there, Scott, so you're first and goal. Looks like around a maybe 2 yard line. So look for Cotton, look for them to pound Cotton up the middle here. Their first touchdown came about the same place here.
Four downs to get it. Hand off Cotton. He's there on the first down, I believe. Yes. Touchdown, Bardstown.
Well, they like to put Sean Hickman in there as a blocker, Scott, and he's a good-sized kid. He goes in there and really opens up the hole with that offensive line, and Cotton bangs in there for another tough touchdown, and Bardstown puts more points on the board. Their confidence looks to be going up a little bit here, Scott.
Two touchdowns here tonight for Bardstown, twice as many as they've scored the entire year. And they lined up for a two-point extra point. Not happy with their extra point conversion game. Having had to change kickers, they're going to stick with going for two. Now Bardstown having confusion getting everybody lined up and on board. And there's the snap. Hand off to Cotton. He's being chased. He's going to make it in, though, for a two-point conversion.
Well, just an easy two-point conversion there by Cotton. Wide open. Sean Hickman, a good job over there blocking for the Tigers. And Jamie Cotton puts two more points on the board. Makes this a four-point ball game here, Scott.
Well, we've got ourselves a house fire ball game out here. This is what we look forward to. This one should be pretty even. And it's turned out to be that way. Nelson County jumping on top. But now Bardstown roaring back here in the third quarter. 20-16. We'll be back with the kickoff after this on PLG Sports.
Farmers Bank and Trust. We're more than just a place for your checking and savings account. We're here to make it easier for you to attain your goals in life. With our four full-service locations, our seven ATMs, our hometown line, and online banking, we make it easy for you every step of the way, from those small purchases to major investments. At Farmers Bank and Trust, we're more than just checking and savings. We're here to make life easier for you.
Nathan Richardson will kick it off. Well, Doug, we finally found ourselves a ball game.
Well, certainly did, and field position paid off there for Bardstown. They took a punt and looked like they might have been about 70 yards there, Scott. So the offense really having a little bit of confidence here as we started this third quarter.
Here comes Nelson County on the kickoff with the football, still carrying it, dancing around at the 40, getting up to the 44-yard line. Give some credit there to Lance Coulter, who caught the ball back at around the 30, danced and jigged and tried to find himself some room, finally got it up to around the 43-yard line.
Well, he certainly did, and he's going to give Nelson County real good field position here. Sean Hickman there on the stop, and Terrell Connor there on the stop for the Tigers. So Bardstown's a special team. He's not real good there. They just couldn't find the handle that time on that Bardstown, on that Nelson County return.
So Harmon is the quarterback. Handoff goes to Primus. Primus has been quiet since the first quarter of play, Doug. They've pretty well closed him down.
Well, they certainly have. Brent Boone's really had the majority of the runs tonight. They've really tried to utilize Primus as a receiver when they see they can get single coverage with him, especially on Chris Payne. But as you said, very quiet on the ground tonight for Ricky Primus. Bartz done a great job on him.
And that defensive change remains in effect with Payne and Cotton.
Certainly. Notice an adjustment they made was they put Jamie Cotton on Ricky Primus now, so they're going to utilize a little bit more speed over there.
Handoff is to Primus, and he tries to go straight ahead. There's nothing there. Primus was the second handoff there. That play has been effective against Bardstown with a fake to the first man, hand to the second. The Bardstown pursuing off the defense has overplayed the ball. But tonight, they're not doing that as much.
No, they're not. And credit Wesley Barnes and Chris Payne, and they're on the stop there for the Tiger. But you're right, Scott. And Bardstown definitely come out, made a good adjustment at halftime. They really shut this running game down of Nelson County. They've done a great job here in this third quarter so far.
So it's third and long, about 11. Two handoffs in the backfield. Coulter winds up with it. Gained about 5 yards, still on his feet. Finally is brought down after a gain of about 5. Two handoff in the backfield before Coulter wound up with the ball.
Yeah, a little double handoff there. Jacob Blackman on the stop there for the Tigers, but Nelson County coming out with a little bit of trickery. They're trying to catch Bardstown off balance there and try to reverse it back to the opposite side of the field there. And a good pursuit there by the Tigers. They're going to get the football back here.
Fourth down, a long 5 to go for the first down. Payne and Hibbs are back for Bardstown. It's a low snap from center, but no rush on, and the kick is away. Takes another Cardinal bounce. It hits Payne in the leg and bounces off. Cardinals are all over it. I think they've got the recovery.
They certainly do. Just unfortunate there for Tigers. Boy, their special team woes just keep happening there. Chris Payne, just the ball just took a crazy hop, bounced right into his leg, as you said there, Scott, in Nelson County, alertly on the football. And boy, that's a big break, as they're going to be inside the 10-yard line. And that's just the break Nelson County was looking for. Just a tough break there for the Tigers.
So down at about the 8-yard line, it's first and goal there. So these Cardinals looking to strike back and get that touchdown right back again. Harmon, the quarterback. Handoff. Boone, and he is breaks one tackle, but is brought down right away. Gain of maybe a yard.
Yeah, that time Brent Boone just trying to go off that right side over there. It was where he's had good success in the first half, but just not much there. And look, maybe dropped the football there, Scott, but alertly picked it up. But they are going to lose a yard, so we'll bring up second and 11 here for the Cardinals.
By 15 to go in the third quarter. Nelson County with the ball, 4-point lead. Handoff, Boone again, straight ahead. Gains about 3, down to the Bardstown 11-yard line.
Good job by Jacob Blackman getting in there for the Tigers. I see one adjustment. As we talked about earlier, Bardstown really done a good job of clogging that middle up, and they looked at doing a good job of off tackles, as Nelson County really had their way with them there on the ground in the first half. Bardstown's made a good adjustment in there, and maybe they're waking up this defense for Barson. There's a lot of names that played last year that have a lot of experience out there, so that they can step up here and get this defense together.
Harmon brings these Cardinals up. He has Coulter out to the right side, and way out left over there is Primus, I think. Hand off up the middle, Boone. And that play worked as they spread the defense out, and Boone slapped it up in the middle and gained it down close to first down yardage, I think, Doug.
Yeah, credit that offensive line in Nelson County. Just a good hole that time. Brent Boone found it. Going to pick up a first down, I believe. Scott, is he going to be a little bit short here?
2 yards short. Fourth and 2.
Well, this is a big play for both teams. If you're Nelson County, you get this first down, you've got 4 plays to score on. If you're Bardstown, you come up with a stop. This really puts some wins back in your sails. You feel like you dodged a bullet here.
Fourth and short. Harmon, the quarterback, keeping himself. Dives forward. I think he's got the first down yardage. Fell in behind his guard and left tackle, or left guard and center. And they got a good, nice charge off of there.
Well, Alan Harmon's he's a big kid, and boy, he lowered himself, and as you said, got behind that offensive line, and is going to pick up a first down. So first and goal here, like about the 2-yard line. So, boy, that was a good drive there by Nelson County, picking up that first down.
Although Bardstown trying to hold now. Nelson County looking to tack more points on. First and goal. And there's a whistle. I believe somebody moved along that line, Doug.
Boy, that's just an unfortunate penalty there, just a mental penalty as you have it first and goal at the 2. Now it's first and goal at the 7. Boy, that makes it a different ball game now.
So now there's a timeout called. And Bardstown takes the timeout. And so with 3:11 to go in the quarter, it's Nelson County 20, Bardstown 16. We'll be back with more play-by-play action when we return after this on PLG Sports.
Kentucky tradition you'll find in Bardstown. Over 80 years, it's true. Our tradition is driven by you. Conway Heat and Ford Chrysler, Bardstown.
Well, Nelson County looking to stick it in the end zone here for their first points in this half, Doug, and they've got it first and goal. Penalty puts it back to the 7-yard line, but it's still first down. Nelson County with the ball. Harmon, the quarterback. Boone in there. He looks to throw. Turns around and cannot release the ball. He's dropped. Harmon went back to throw and was decked.
He certainly was. Watch Adam Butler. Just a great play there getting in the backfield to Alan Harmon. What Nelson County was trying to do that time, it looked like, as we talked about earlier, Bardstown's made an adjustment. They put Jamie Cotton on Ricky Primus over there on that wide side of the field, and it looked like they were going to try to hit Primus on a little slant pattern in the middle that time. And boy, credit Adam Butler just getting in the backfield, making a big play there for the Tigers.
It's second down and 15, second and goal at the 15-yard line of Bardstown. And here goes Bolter with a handoff in there. And he's met in the backfield, goes backwards, and Bardstown's really fired up.
Well, they certainly are. And boy, Adam Butler, just another great play. Two plays in a row by Adam Butler. Lance Coulter that time was the ball carrier, just nowhere to go, just met right as he cut the football. And Bardstown's defense is really backing this Cardinal team up, Scott. Looks like third and about 22 here. So,
third and goal from the 22.
Exactly right. So two big plays there by the Tigers.
So Nelson County up here has gone backwards in a hurry. Harmon to throw. There's one out there to the far side to Primus at the end zone. Incomplete, overthrowing. Good thought on that one. They've been running him in all the time. This time they did it out with him, Primus, and almost had him.
Certainly did. They faked him in that time, and Primus did a little out paddle. And Harmon was trying to throw it over his shoulder that time, and just not a real good throw there by Harmon. And Bardstown really, really dodged the bullet there, Scott. And fourth down here, and it looks like Nelson County may be trying to go for a field goal.
Be an extra long one.
38-yarder here for Nelson County.
Lance Smith to kick. It's up. He's got the distance. Looks like it might drop over. Does. Good. 23-16.
Wow. Well, that's a great kick.
What about that one?
Absolutely. Just Lance Smith just put that one just barely right over. As you said, Scott, it just barely skimmed over there. But that's a big field goal there. They walk away with some points. That moves out to a 7-point ball game. Boy, that's a big field goal there by the Cardinals.
Oh, yeah. Minute 37 to go in quarter number 3. They'll kick it off. Nelson County will after that field goal. We'll return with more action here from Garnes Martin Field after this message.
St. Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
Well, Bardstown's got to feel good somewhat about that defensive stand. On the other hand, Nelson County, something to pat themselves on the back with. They came up with a good field goal with a long one at that.
Absolutely. I think both teams really felt like they came away with something there. Bardstown didn't give up a touchdown, and Nelson County gets a field goal.
This kick goes to the end zone. First one we've seen into the end zone tonight. Cotton was back there, just let it dance around in the end zone and comes out to the 20.
Well, good kick there for the Cardinals, and going to put Bardstown on the 20-yard line there. So Bardstown really needs to get something going. It looked to have a little confidence as they marched right down the field their last possession and scored a nice touchdown, went 70 yards. And see if this Bardstown confidence on offensively can stay with them here.
Richardson is in the shotgun to start this series off. Handoff is to Shekels, and boy, he is met in the backfield, nothing going. As the Nelson County defense stiffens up right there.
Yeah, just a good pursuit there by the Cardinals getting in the backfield.
Loss of about four.
Looked to be another busted play there, Scott. I don't know if that was really intended to go to Wesley Shekels or not, but he ended up with the football and just nowhere to go. Yeah, so credit that Nelson County defense with a four-yard loss.
So Bardstown backed with a second and 14. Richardson looks to do something, wings it out there to Cotton. It's incomplete over his head. The ball wasn't thrown very much forward, Doug, but just enough to be named a forward pass.
Certainly did, and the Nelson County coaching staff really thought that could have been. It was very close there. That side judge right on top of it, though. So fortunately for Bardstown, it's going to be an incomplete pass, but it is going to bring up third and 14 here. And, boy, credit this Nelson County defense. They've really stepped up here, and they're getting in that backfield.
Just as the Bardstown defense did the last time when Nelson County had the ball. Now it's turned around and the Cardinal defense has stepped up. So it's third and long. From the shotgun, Bardstown will try to pick it up. Richardson looks for some help, wings it out here, and it's going to be picked off. Nelson County intercepts it. And they have it down at the Bardstown 10-yard line, or close to it. Number two on the interception, Doug.
Stephen Kreps just stepped right in there. Nathan Richardson's pass was intentionally supposed to go to number eight of Bardstown, and that's Sean Hickman. But credit Kreps, he stepped right in front there with an easy interception and going to give Nelson County good field position.
And worse than that, Nathan Richardson's down on the field after the play.
Well, let's just hope that's a cramp, Scott. He looks to be in a lot of pain down there in his left leg. And, boy, let's just hope that is a cramp. But coaching staff and the medical staff out there for the Tigers. But, boy, it looked to be in a lot of pain there. It could be scary there. They need this young man.
So 38 seconds remaining here in the quarter. Nathan up now and hobbling, but up and coming over to the sideline.
Well, that's good news there. I really think it's just a cramp, hopefully. And I just don't think he can get it out. Looks to be in his calf. As we saw, Jamie Cotton had a cramp earlier in the third quarter. And cramps, you know, it's a hot night tonight. And both these young men go both ways, offensive and defensive. Played a lot of minutes tonight. And that fatigue factor sets in. That's when those cramps come.
So it's 23-16 here in the third quarter with under 40 seconds to go. And on the interception, Nelson County has it. It's first down. 10 from about, what, the 12-yard line? And Harmon with a chance to really tack on some points here in this quarter. Hands it off to Boone. Boone stopped after a loss of maybe a yard. Yeah, like maybe a yard loss.
Credit Jason Riley that time getting in there for the Tigers. Going to lose a yard there as we wind down here, Scott, into this third quarter, 20 seconds. This could be the last play, but that could have been the last play. I don't know if Nelson will get this off or not. They may here.
We're down 10 seconds. Harmon is the quarterback under center. Coulter in motion. Harmon rolls to the left. Tux keeps himself at the line of scrimmage, maybe gained a yard. And he is wrapped up right there, and that ends the quarter. With the score, 23-16, Nelson County over Bardstown. At the end of three, Nelson County at the Tiger 10 when the quarter ends. We'll be back after this.
If you've got a plan, Wilson and Muir has the financing. Construction loans, permanent loans. We can help every step of the way and at the most competitive rates available. We offer a full array of mortgage options to get you the right mortgage. Fixed rate, conventional, single, and multifamily residents, all from the folks you know and trust. So see your mortgage professionals. Wilson and Muir Bank and Trust. We're all bank for Hardin and Nelson counties.
Community Bank. When choosing a bank, you should look at more than the services it has to offer. You should look at the personal service that's provided to you. At Community Bank, we're a local bank, deep-rooted in the community, and we care about our customers and about making banking easy for you. Our staff at each of our locations pledge to give you the quality, convenient, and personal service you expect from your bank. At Community Bank, it's banking the way it was meant to be, face-to-face.
12 more minutes to go, Doug, and this game's not over yet.
Well, it's certainly not. Just been a great ball game here. As Bardstown really got on the scoreboard there, made it a good ball game. Nelson County with a field goal there late in the third quarter. This is a big play here, Scott, for both teams. Third and eight here. Bardstown needs a stop. Nelson County really needs a first down to keep this drive going.
Harmon's the quarterback from the spread. A little pitch. It's to Boone. Boone tries to get to the outside, not going to be there. He's going to be well short of the first down, barely got back to the line of scrimmage.
Certainly did. Jacob Blackman did a great job of getting over there and making a stop over there. As he looked to make a shoestring tackle as Boone looked to maybe tried to elude that tackle, but a good job by Blackman. He's going to bring up fourth down here. And we've seen a field goal once. I'll look for another one here.
Yep, you're right. Much shorter than the last one. They're going to spot this ball down inside the 20. It's going to be spotted down at about the 16-yard line. It's down. It's up. Plenty long enough and right through the uprights. Beautiful kick.
Great.
I mean,
kick.
He nailed that one.
Beautiful. Lance Coulter, another big tax. Three big points on there for the Cardinals. And moves it out here, Scott, to a 10-point ball game. So had the little breathing room there for the Cardinals. But boy, has a big field goal.
Yep. So the score now moves out, as you said, to a score of 26-16. And Bardstown, with their backs to the wall here in this fourth quarter, will take the kickoff. See if they can gear up their offense. We'll come back and check out the kickoff and the rest of the game. Well, we'll keep it right here because they're just about ready to move things along. Brian Kellum, our executive producer this evening, has his fingers on the trigger, ready to pull it. Not yet, Ryan. Well, Bardstown has not fared well on any punt or kickoff tonight, have they, Doug?
No, not special teams. Hasn't been too kind here for the Tigers. Really been backbreakers. You know, you think of the kickoff to start the ball game, and then you think about the punt down here a while ago going off Chris Payne's foot. Just hadn't really gone their way on special teams. But you got a kicker like this for Nelson County, puts it pretty down there pretty deep.
Well, he does, and Cotton picks it up, drops the ball, picks it up again, goes forward, has his feet slip out from under him. I think he's inside the 10-yard line.
Yeah, he certainly is. Going to be around the 6 or 7-yard line. Just couldn't get his footing there. And it's going to really pin the Tigers deep in their own field position. And, boy, that's just good special teams coverage there for the Cardinals. Just another unfortunate break on special teams there for the Tigers, Scott. They've just been snake-bitten here.
Well, Cotton, don't say that he misplayed it. He just didn't catch it. Wasn't over his head. He just bounced off his shoulder pads and... As a result, we've got terrible field position for Bardstown. First and 10 at about your own 6-yard line. A Here comes the runner-up. The middle, is that Hibbs carrying the ball?
It'll be Jamie Cotton or Scott.
Cotton, okay.
And tried to cut back to the middle that time, and good pursuit in there for the Cardinals. Justin Smith looks like was in there for the Cardinals.
Comes out across the 10-yard line to about the 11. Gain of 2, second and 8. Bardstown needs to have a quick hitter here to pick up a couple first downs.
Yeah, they sure do. They need two scores, and yeah, they really need to get something here. It's got a 10-19 mark here in the fourth quarter.
And it's Cotton. He's sweeping to the left side. Cuts it back in short of the end, and thought he could pick up a little more that way. He does, but gets short yardage. Gains about 4.
Yeah, just really not much there again. Jamie Cotton, Scott, maybe picked up a yard there. Third and long here for the Tigers.
Oh, here's a flag on the play. Also, this one looks to be going against Bardstown, Doug.
Yeah, I think they're going to get a holding penalty there, Scott, and that'll back it up 10 yards, and that's going to put them real deep, in maybe around the 5, inside the 5.
All right, that's going to take it back to nose the ball just short of the 5.
Do get a down back.
Yeah, second down and about 14. And now Richardson has Sheckles in the backfield with him along with Cotton. And they hand off. We may have a safety on this one, is carrying the ball out there.
Chris Payne.
Right.
Scott, yeah, coming around. Looked like he was going to be a little end around there. And boy, credit Brandon Simpson, number 12 there for the Cardinals. Really read that well. Got back there, made a good play, and it is going to be a safety. And boy, just a tough break there for the Tigers. But boy, credit that county, Nelson County defense. Boy, they just stepped up there when they needed to and made a good play there. Going to add 2 more points on the scoreboard.
Yep, that makes it 28 to 16. And Bardstown has to get rid of the football. As we said, they have their choice of kicking by placement or by punt. They'll kick it from their own 20-yard line. Well, let's see, are there any other ways that Nelson County can score tonight? Field goal.
They've scored. Absolutely. They scored
touchdown,
on a pass play.
And a safety, right?
That's right. They've busted it up the middle. They've thrown a pass play to Ricky Primus. They've scored, as you said, on a safety. Had a field goal. And they've really kind of done it all here tonight. And they came in with a lot of confidence. They came off with a big 27-6 win last week against Franklin County. They played 2 good football teams in Lexington Catholic and Paul Dunbar, you know, 2 ranked teams.
Yep.
And they thought they played well. And they come in tonight with a lot of confidence.
Bridgetown kicks. Taken at the 25-26-yard line by Simpson. He brings it up to the 45-yard line, 47, before he's brought down. First and 10, Nelson County there.
Well, good play there by Bardstown. That's going to be Michael Kimberlin. They're on a stop there. Or excuse me, let me check that. That's going to be Chad Ward there on a stop there for Bardstown. So good field position here for Nelson County. And I would doubt very seriously if you'll see Nelson County put this thing in the air, Scott. They'll probably just look to grind this clock out as they're up 12 points here, and they know the clock is definitely on their side.
Yep. Harmon, the quarterback. And straight ahead, beg your pardon, they hand it to Primus. He sweeps around the right side. He's at the sideline. He may go down into deep Bardstown territory at the 23 or 4-yard line. Penalty marker comes in at the end of the play, and that's going to be bad news for Bardstown.
Absolutely. They're probably going to get a personal foul or unsportsmanlike over there on that right side over there, Scott. I don't know who I hate to speculate who it could be. It could be a 2 or 3 Tigers. Could be maybe Wesley Barnes, I don't know, but boy, Ricky Primus hit that side full speed and had good upfield blocking. and picked up great yardage there for the Cardinals. They're going to tack 15 more yards on here, and that's going to be bad for the Tigers. As you mentioned earlier, Scott, they've had good success on that second man through that time, right. And they faked it up there to Boone and hit Primus, and boy, he had a world of daylight around that right side.
And that's going to take it down around the, 12-yard line? Wait till they get through walking and marching, and we'll find out. 14-yard line, right?
Yeah, Scott, looks like around between the 13 and 14 down there, so a great field position here for the Cardinals.
First down and 10. Harmon, the quarterback, has three receivers out wide to the left side. One back in there with him. Hands it off, Boone. Boone spins out of the tackle at the line of scrimmage, and there was no one there. If he could have kept his footing, he'd have been in the end zone.
Certainly did, and boy, I tell you, just a great run there by Brent Boone. He hits that hole hard, Scott. He's a hard runner, and he looks to have a little bit of power on him in there. Looks to be a pretty strong young man. And boy, when he finds those holes, he hits them hard. And that time, as you said, if it wasn't for his knee, maybe touching our shoestring tackle there for the Tigers, could have been six there for Nelson County.
As it is, it's down at the four, where it's second and inches for the first down. Four for the touchdown. Harmon keeps it and goes forward. He's got the first down yardage.
That quarterback sneak there, Alan Harmon, just picking up that first down and going to give him first and goal here around the 2-yard line. So maybe around the one there, Scott. It's close.
Certainly four times to hammer it in there to try and get it across. For Nelson County, who this just might be the icing on the cake here, I think, Doug.
I believe you're right there. And boy, look for Brent Boone to get the carry here off tackles. That's what really been successful here for Cardinals tonight. I look for them to bang him off tackle.
Hand off. Well, they fake it to Boone, and Harmon keeps it, rolls it over his own left right tackle and rolls into the end zone.
Well, just a good play there. Alan Harmon fakes it to the pull back that time, Brent Boone, and takes it around the right side. Good blocking for the Cardinals and puts 6 points there on the Cardinals. As you said, Scott, big time trouble here for the Tigers.
So Bardstown gives up another touchdown, and the extra point is coming up by Lance Smith, the young man who's got two field goals and has played well for the Cardinals tonight. Kick down, plenty distance on this one, looks pretty good. So now the score expands 35-16. Nelson County over Bardstown here in the fourth quarter with still 7:56 to play. We'll be back with the kickoff when we return on PLG Sports. So Nelson County set to kick it off. And Doug, you and I have mentioned too many times tonight that the Bardstown special teams have not fared well at all.
No.
And unfortunately, they have a chance to show something tonight. Maybe they can improve.
Well, I think that's one area that they definitely see they're going to have to improve on. And their decision-making on punts isn't real good. And, of course, their kickoff returns haven't been really great either, so that's just something they're going to have to really work on, Scott, is they got a long task ahead of them.
Here's Cotton. He takes it, comes straight up the field, breaks through the first line of defense, keeps his feet under him, gets it up to about the 30-yard line. Nice run buck by Jamie Cotton.
Well, certainly was. He found a good hole in there that time and brought down that time by 81 Anthony Hurst for Nelson County, so going to give him a little breathing room here as they just going to be shy of the 30-yard line.
Well, at a time of the game when you have to throw because you're behind and it's the fourth quarter, and you've got Nathan Richardson who hasn't shown the ability to throw at all tonight.
Well, that's right. You know, in his third game, doesn't seem real comfortable out there, and he's definitely in a position now where he's going to have to throw the football, and two things either happen. Your confidence either goes down or you step up and you start making big plays, and this is going to give this kid a lot of confidence here, and he's going to need it because Bardstown's going to have to throw, Scott, the rest of this football season. I mean, there's going to be teams they're going to have to throw against.
We have an injured Bardstown player. He just dropped down in the huddle.
Yeah, I think it's going to be another cramp there. Maybe Jamie Cotton looks like Scott, and we saw in the third quarter he had cramp problems as they were working on him on the sidelines, and I think that cramp may have reoccurred there in that calf. Just can't get it to go away. Sometimes that happens, and boy, it's just frustrating. Any movement you do, it just comes back, and boy, it's painful.
Well, so there's a hesitation in the play as we work over the injured player on the field. And we're helping Jamie to his feet now. What's the ruling on that, Doug? Does he have to come out for one play?
Yeah, I believe he does, Scott. He had to seek medical attention. I believe he has to come out for one play. So they'll try to hobble him off here. That cramp just will not go away. And
Cotton under his own momentum now. Coming to the sideline to the applause from the Bardstown fans. The faithful appreciate his work tonight. He's been a yeoman.
Absolutely. Both sides of the football, he's made some big plays on defense. They've had to put him over there on the speedster Ricky Primus, and certainly been the workload on offense for the Tigers tonight.
So Richardson has the Tigers set on offense. Shekels and Hibbs in the backfield. Hand off to Hibbs. Hibbs ducks away from one tackle, still on his feet. Gets through the line of scrimmage and is met by the linebackers back there and brought down after a gain of about three or four.
Yeah, Jonathan Hibbs, just a quick hitter off the left side over there. It's like Justin Smith and Lance Coulter over there for the Cardinals on the stop. And I can assure you, Jamie Cotton won't be out very long because who's he can get that cramp to go away? They'll get him back out there, but boy, he's played a lot of minutes tonight.
So we've got second down here and about 5 yards to go for Bardstown. This is Shekels. Shekels comes to the outside, turns the corner, has the feet go out from under him as he gets across the 40-yard line to about the 43.
Certainly did. Great run there by Wesley Shekels. Turned the corner that time. Good. Had a good little assist upfield blocking that time, and going to pick up first down.
So first down for the Tigers at the 38-yard line. I'll make that the 43-yard line. Bardstown offense showing a little life here in the fourth quarter with 6:48 to go in the game. Shekels again carries inside the tackles, gets it across the 45 to about the 46.
And Wesley Shekels just up the middle of that time, Chance Downs. We'll stop there for the Cardinals, along with big 71 there. That's Andrew Newton. Scott, Bardstown's down 19 points here. Definitely keeping on the ground. This clock's definitely running down here. We're getting close to the 6-minute mark.
Yep. Richardson throws one out in the flat. And it's caught and bringing it back to the line of scrimmage. And now, I don't think that's the way that play is supposed to work, is it, Doug?
No, nothing there that time. I think they tried to set up a little bit of a wall there for Sean Hickman that time. Just nothing there. Just great defensive stop there by the Cardinals. As you said, may have been a busted play again there, Scott. But Hickman just nowhere to go.
I think he was looking for somebody to lateral that ball to.
Well, he may have been. They need to come up with something big here, Scott. We're down to 5:30 mark here, and this clock just winding down, and Bardstown just didn't look like they're in much of a hurry here offensively.
We're at third down and about seven. Now there's a timeout called, and it's going to be charged to Bardstown. Well, we've got timeout for Bardstown. As they seem to be in a little disarray, we'll call time in for this and return to BLG Sports.
At Farmers Bank and Trust, we give the phrase banker's hours a whole new meaning. With our community involvement, we work weekends for charitable events such as Habitat for Humanity, the Bob Murray Heart Walk, Relay for Life, and the Kentucky Colonel's Barbecue. We work evening hours for community events such as the Christmas Parade, the Taste of Desserts, and the United Way. At Farmers Bank and Trust, we give the phrase banker's hours a whole new meaning.
So we're back here at Bardstown Garnet Spartan Field. The Tigers face third down in a long 7 yards to go. And they've called the timeout. They were in a little disarray offensively there, Doug. I think they still might be.
Yeah, they just kind of gone that way tonight offensively for the Tigers all night long.
And it's Richardson to throw. A little short pass over the middle. And Hickman, I don't know, he was there. I thought the ball looked pretty well thrown. Hickman just couldn't come up with it.
Yeah, just Nathan may have thrown that one just a little bit short there. It looked like he didn't have much pressure. Chance Downs, but maybe he applied a little bit of pressure, but Nathan looked like he stepped out of the pocket nicely that time and just wasn't able to put out a good throw that time. And Sean Hickman unsuccessful to make the catch. It looked like Wesley Sheckles was out there as well, wide open down the middle. We've seen him wide open quite a bit tonight.
And, yeah.
Just haven't hit him yet.
So it goes to fourth down, and Richardson moves back to punt. Here comes a kick straight up in the air and kind of short and takes a bounce sideways. Bardstown surrounds it, and I think they're going to call it down at the 35-yard line of Nelson County.
Well, Tommy Pyle did a good job of coming in there and putting pressure. Made Richardson had to hurry that out of there. Went straight up in there and just didn't go very far. So Nelson County going to get good field position here and look for them to grind this clock down.
5 minutes to go in the game. And Bardstown, a failed offensive maneuver in that series, gives the ball back to Nelson County.
Not real sure there, Scott, why. You know, Bardstown had the ball near midfield there. Don't understand why you just don't take a crack at you down, you know, 19 points here. You definitely got to try to get something there. Punt the ball away, and Nelson County's going to use this clock.
Harmon, the quarterback, hands it off. Boone breaks a tackle, gets a couple of yards, and is brought down. Jamie Cotton on the stop.
Yeah, good play there by Cotton. Boone just picking up 3 yards there for the Cardinals, just trying to find something off that left side over there. Just not much energy there on that Bardstown defense, Scott. They've just looked like they've just lost their, just don't have much life in them out there. Coach Downs and his staff really have a tough chore task here to get this team to bounce back as they're going to start district play.
Here's a handoff going to Kreps on the right side. He turns the corner, turns on the speed midfield. Bardstown territory at the 40, 35-30. Cotton misses a tackle at the 30, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown.
Well, we talked about it. Bardstown just looks like they're just out of gas out there that time defensively, and just a good touchdown run there by Nelson County. Boy, when they hit that right-hand side, Scott, they just gone. Good upfield blocking there by the Cardinals, and another long run for the Cardinals as they've just caught this Bardstown defense off balance again.
But do we have a flag down on play, Doug?
Yeah, I believe we do there, Scott. It's on the opposite side of the field over there on the – and I do see it sitting. No, I couldn't tell if that's a flag or Jamie Cotton's shoes, one or the other. but definitely a flag, and this probably could be coming back here, Scott.
Well, that'll be the only thing that'll save the touchdown. Because Nelson County was on the move.
Well, certainly was. They're just, they'll assess the penalty from the spot of the foul. So Nelson County's going to get, they're going to end up with good field position here. Is that looks like they're going to get it around the 40-yard line. So, but boy, that just takes away a great play there by the Cardinals. That was a great run.
Great run by Stephen Kreps. He really had things going for him on that one. Well, it's still a first down at the Bardstown 40-yard line. Kreps in motion. Try the same play again. Kreps with it. cuts back. This time, Bardstown snuffs it out, a gain of about four on the carry.
Yeah, Stephen Krebs again, pretty much the same play they did, just didn't have as much real estate to work with over there on that right side, but a good pursuit there by the Tigers, and going to pick up, as you said, Scott, a good tough 4 or 5 yards there.
Nelson County putting new players into that backfield, Doug. Fresh jerseys in there.
Sure, it's a good time to give kids some experience. You know, you look to your future, and you got a big lead here, and as you said, fresh legs. And I guess a very tired Bardstown defense.
Harmon, the quarterback. And off to Coulter. Coulter met at the line of scrimmage. Dives forward, maybe gained a yard.
Yeah, Lance Coulter picking up a little bit of yardage there for the Cardinals.
Third down coming up. Greg Brussel into the lineup for Nelson County in the backfield. Matt Rogers also in there in the county lineup. Handoff goes over there to Russell, I believe. Yeah. And a little gain.
Yeah, Matt Rogers, Scott. He's a 5'9", 167-pound freshman. Getting some good experience in there for the Cardinals tonight. Well, that brings up fourth down, a long yardage here for Nelson County.
So with a fourth down play coming up, Nelson County probably will accept a delay of game penalty by letting the clock go down as we really move down to under 2 minutes.
Yep, absolutely, Scott. That's exactly what they're going to do. And they'll look to punt this away, but as you said, 1:47 to go here. And Nelson County definitely will take a penalty here. No loss here. And punt it and let that clock run.
Move it back to the 42-yard line. Nelson County sends the punt unit in. So Bardstown, no one back deep to receive, Doug. They're all midfield. Now there's another penalty down.
Waved his flag off, I believe. I don't know. Yeah, he's waving it off, so I don't know what he originally threw it for.
I don't either. He probably thought it was a delay of game, but you can't have a delay of game because you never started the clock.
That's right.
After the last one, right?
That's exactly right. So I guess Nelson County is going to call a timeout here, talk things over.
So there's a timeout on the field for Nelson County, and while we have that timeout, let's call time in for this message on PLG Sports.
Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
So with fourth down, Nelson County, after the timeout, set to punt it away from their own, from the Bardstown 42. There's the kick. It's a nice high kick, short. Bardstown takes the catch and drops it, and Nelson County may have picked the ball up. I think they did.
They certainly did. Number 60 for Nelson County. That's going to be a Matt Hicks, and Jonathan Hibbs called for the fair catch down. It didn't look like he had a lot of room to catch the football there, Scott, as Hicks was really on top of him. And I'm really surprised we didn't see a flag there as he was right. He didn't look like he gave him much room at all. But credit Hicks there for the fumble recovery, and it's going to give Nelson County a great field position inside the Bardstown 10-yard line.
Right at the 10-yard line where it's first and goal. New quarterback in there for Nelson County. And we'll pick that up for you as they run it straight ahead. Short gain there. Into the game is Brandon Mauser at quarterback. Mauser is a sophomore. Short yardage gain, couple maybe. Second down, game still has a minute 10 to go. Man in motion, Mauser with the ball, keeps, tucks it under, goes to the end zone, got it in there. Touchdown, Nelson
Certainly
County.
Certainly did. Boy, just a little bootleg or outside on that right-hand side, and boy, just good blocking there for the Cardinals, and an easy touchdown that time for Brandon Mauser. So the 5'9", 150-pound sophomore comes in, and boy, does a great job. Two plays, scores a touchdown there for the Cardinals, and I know that'll be a highlight of his career.
Right.
So far, and just a good run there by Mauser.
To attack the extra point, Lance Smith. And we've got an encroachment penalty as defense across the line and half the distance here. Extra point up, and it's good. And that moves it out down to a 42-16 score with a minute to go. Nelson County over Bardstown, 42-16. Welcome back with the final few seconds of this game after this on PLG Sports.
If you've got a plan, Wilson and Muir has the financing. Construction loans, permanent loans. We can help every step of the way and at the most competitive rates available. We offer a full array of mortgage options to get you the right mortgage. Fixed rate, conventional, single, and multifamily residents, all from the folks you know and trust. So see your mortgage professionals. Wilson and Muir Bank and Trust. We're all bank for Hardin and Nelson counties.
And now, Bardstown to receive the kick. Boy, this has been a real Achilles mark on the Tigers, this kicking situation. They have not fielded the ball well. They've not played the kicks well. They've not caught them when they've called for a fair catch. And it's really hurt them.
Yeah, it certainly has. Special teams for Bardstown's really probably played a big part in this ball game tonight. But I tell you what, Coach Downs and his staff really have a big chore at hand. They know what they really need to work on. And, boy, I would spend a lot of time next week on special teams because, boy, they sure need it, Scott. Got a new kick returner back here for Bardstown. It's going to be 14. That's Quasi, I guess, Obing. He's a 5'4", 120-pound freshman.
Here's the kick. It's deep. Quasi Obey picks it up and goes backwards to the 5-yard line and is dropped there.
Yeah, just Nelson County, boy, their special teams has improved so much from last year, and I tell you that I think that's going to play a big part in their season. They've really gotten down there great on their kickoffs. Their punts have been pretty good tonight. They're getting down there covering punts well. And this special teams for Nelson County really bothered them last year, but boy, they're much improved here. And boy, just the opposite for Bardstown. Their special teams last year were fantastic. You had Randy Tongue, you had so much speed, you had good blocking, and boy, they've just got a lot of work to do here as they're going to enter district play here, Scott.
So the ball's at the 12-yard line for Bardstown. Final few plays. Richardson, deep pitch back to Shekels. Shekels hit at the line of scrimmage, dances around forward. Gains a couple, but that's it.
Yeah, Chris Noel on the stop there for the Cardinals. And that's probably going to be the last play of the night, Scott, I would say.
Under 40 seconds to go. Now we're marking it on down under 30. Ball is marked as set for play. We We're at 20 seconds and the clock continuing to run. Bardstown will snap the ball and that'll be about it. Richardson moves up under center, takes the ball, has it, runs around a little bit, and goes down at the line of scrimmage. And that should do it with 4 seconds, and that'll do it.
Well, just a very happy Nelson County team, Scott. They came in with a great game plan. Really got the job done tonight. They came in, you know, just really much smash-mouth football. Had good success on the ground. The passing game was there with Ricky Primus. And Bardstown just not able to get it done here tonight, Scott. They've got a lot of work to do.
42-16, our final score. The Nelson County Cardinals over the Tigers, who remain winless on this season. We'll be back and recap the second half scoring when we return to PLG's Bardstown Tiger Field after these messages.
Kentucky tradition, you'll find in Bardstown. Over 80 years, it's true. Our tradition is driven by you. Conway Heat and Ford Chrysler, Bardstown.
St. Catherine College, a rich tradition of education and opportunity. Whether you've just graduated from high school or want a new direction for your life, St. Catherine College is the answer for the traditional and non-traditional student. St. Catherine offers the best educational and training opportunities in the area with a convenient Bardstown campus and financial assistance available. St. Catherine has a long-standing winning tradition in men's and women's sports. St. Catherine College, an opportunity that will last a lifetime. Call 1-800-599-2000.
Doug, we had a game about midway through the third quarter when Bardstown scored a touchdown, closed it up to 20-16. And then the roof fell in.
Well, it certainly did, Scott. I tell you, you know, Bardstown did exactly what they wanted to do there in the start of the second half. They held Nelson County, got good field position, marched 70 yards down the field, and boy, made it a 20-16 ball game. We thought we had a great ball game coming, as you said, Scott. Boy, mistakes came in for the Bardstown Tigers. Special teams and turnovers just killed them tonight.
And the final score, 42-16. Let's see how the Cardinals racked up those points.
Okay, Scott. Well, our first score came in the third quarter at the 8-19 mark. Jamie Cotton, a two-yard TD run. The two-point conversion was good as Jamie Cotton run was good. Jamie had all 16 points tonight for the Tigers. The second score came with a minute 37 in the third quarter. Lance Smith, a big 38-yard field goal, had moved up to 23-16. And then we moved into the fourth quarter, Scott, at the 11-13 mark. Lance Smith, another big field goal for Nelson County. It moved it up to 26-16. And then at the 9:24 mark in the fourth quarter, we had a safety, a Brandon Simpson tackle on a Chris Payne in the end zone. It moved out to 28-16. And then at the 7:56 mark, Alan Harmon, a two-yard TD run. Lance Smith kick was good. That moved it to 35-16. And the last score of the night, the freshman, Brandon Mauser, six-yard TD run. The Lance Smith kick was good. 42-16, 26-point victory tonight for the Cardinals. Just total domination. They capitalized on the mistakes of the Tigers.
They certainly did, and they took advantage of them. They improved their record to 2-2 on the season. Bardstown at least got some points on the board for the first time this year. They're 0-3 on the season in the inter-district play next week.
That's right, Scott. Boy, this coaching staff has really had their work cut out for them as they've got a lot of things to work on, special teams. Really need to work on their offense, and boy, their defense is just really, really getting ran over. They hadn't been able to stop that running game so far yet. Boy, district play, they got their work cut out for them.
You're right. We're going to pick up on the Bethlehem Eagles next Saturday afternoon, and we'll be there with that from Lally Field. Hope to see you Sunday evening next week here on PLG Sports. I'm Scott Cederholm.
And I'm Doug Johnson.
We'll see you then.